it's not up for you and I to do it. If it's harmful and they still want to do it, they are free to do it, right? I mean, you say that what people want to do in their bedroom, it's an individual choice. We if women want to enter it, say, they want to enter it, who has to stop
you,
it?
You ask a question, please. You please ask a question. I'm not that dumb that a question needs to be explained to me.
Angad has already chosen, so if you could give, and then we'll move on to Joe, because Joe, I mean, some people there also, because he's been raising his hands in some time. And then we'll move on to Joe, because Joe, I mean, some people there also, because he's been raising his hands in some time. The next person, if I'm not wrong, was Joe, so he'll be...
You got all everything set, huh?
Hello, Jaggi Vasudev, sir. Before I ask my question, I just have to tell you that I was very impressed by your e-commerce website, which sells yoga merchandise. I think it's really cool. It's better than Flipkart and Amazon, and I hope that, you know, in a few years' time, it'll become the biggest e-commerce company.
It's a conscious decision I've taken that our commerce part is done just to take care of a few things. Our commerce will never grow beyond the foundation part. I clearly made the distinction, there's Isha Foundation and there's Isha Business. And we have contained the business in spite of enormous demand. We have contained the business because...
Yeah. So it's very impressive, sir.
No, you should not be impressed by that. You must come and see what I do otherwise.
Yeah. Sir,
the real thing.
My question... I want to tell you that I was also very impressed by your commitment to rule of law that was evident from the discussions that we've had. In the same light, I just want to ask you that in one of the blogs that you have written in your website, you speak about women's entry to Shaini temples, and there you say that, look, the reason why they shouldn't be allowed is because there are planetary forces and it's not good for women to enter these temples. In the same vein, I just want to tell you a little bit about the law on the point. There are Supreme Court judgments which say that if you make laws which tend to be discriminatory for women, it cannot be a justification that we are doing it for their benefit. That cannot be the justification for any law that discriminate against women. This is the law of the land. in that same vein, would you say that if that is the law of the land and you're committed to the ideals of law, then one, how do you justify that?
Yes.
And two, one more question, sir.
Let me see.
Just a follow-up question. The second part of the question is, in the same article, you also mentioned that we can control the impact of planetary forces on our life through inner engineering. What is inner engineering? Is it a program that Isha Foundation hands out? What exactly is inner engineering? Is it something that you guys do? And like if you guys can tell us what is inner engineering, only then will we be able to, you know, face the forces of planetary forces. What exactly is this concept of inner engineering?
Okay. We'll answer that. So right now, why don't you ask this institution, Nalsar? Only if you tell us what is law, we will know what's the law. What is it?
I'm sorry, sir, could you clarify that? I didn't get what you just said. Like,
No. You tell your institution in which you are, only if you trap us here for 5 years and tell us what is the law, will we understand what is the law? Don't we know? Well, only because you do not know, you have come here, right, to learn. Similarly, only because people could not figure it out by themselves, they have come. And only because it's working for them, they're coming in millions. Okay, you have 700 people here, we have 9 million volunteers working across the world. So, it must be working for them. So do not make these judgments and don't think it's very smart to simply make judgments on everything. You are a lawyer, you are not a judge, all right? So let's come to the question. See, so please don't do these things. It is happening from both segments of people. What you like, boo, you shout and clap, please don't do that. For or against, that's not the way. The way to do this is, are we interested in knowing and enhancing? You ask a question as a way to enhance your knowing, not just to prove that you are smart. If you think you can prove you are smart, we will do something else to that. Anyway. You asked this question, I like the e-commerce, I know when you started off, I know when Joe is called, why he is called, we know what it is, I'm not that dumb, okay? When I sit here, when I just look at you, I know what you can ask, I will tell you. Let me tell you this, hollow. When I train teachers to handle engineering programs, now we have transformed the program in a different way, but at one time when it was very intense, I trained the teachers like this. Somebody walks into the hall, they settle down here today by themselves without being guided. You just see, I made a chart of the hall and said, see, if they sit here, if they sit here, if they sit here, this is the question they will ask. You just be ready. When he raises his question, you know this is what he will ask. 93% to 94% of the time, it's always right like that. People think they are free and they're asking questions, but if they sit in that place, that's a question they will ask. In any venue, not in any particular venue, just anywhere, this may not look logical to you, but life happens like that anyway. So now when you start praising the e-commerce, I know why it is, it's not that you're appreciating it. I'm telling you, Asia Foundation is a foundation run by the volunteers. Over 4,600 full-time volunteers who are far more educated than you are, and over 9 million part-time volunteers across the world, giving their time and money and energy to make this happen. Why are people doing this? We're not promising them we'll take you to heaven. We're not telling you you will go and sit in God's lap. Why are they doing it? It must be done wonders to them, otherwise why will they invest their life in it? So without knowing anything, don't make conclusions. So are you the only one? Well, you can do it in so many other ways. If you knew how to figure it out, why would I be needed? You do not know how to figure it out, so somebody comes and helps. If somebody comes and helps, why are you helping people? You leave them with their problems, they'll be good business for a lawyer. Is that what you're talking to me? Please, don't feed upon people's problems. People have problems. If you have a solution, it's good. If you don't have a solution, at least leave them alone. Now, about commerce, we have every day in the yoga center, the minimum meal is around 7,000 people per meal. On the weekends, it's 15,000 to 20,000. Whoever comes, nobody inquires, who are you, why are you eating here? Whoever comes, they're welcomed and they're fed, all right? And we are running 12 schools in rural, in remotest parts of India, which is the same level of education that one would get in a good urban school, and 40% of the children are first generation going to school. Over 9,000 children are sponsored fully for their entire education. And we have medical activity going on across Tamil Nadu in a big way. There are many other aspects which I don't want to go on listing. For all this to happen, it needs a certain financial thing. Now if I come to you with a begging bowl, you will say, why have you come to me with a begging bowl? If I earn my own money, you are saying, why are you earning your own money? What is the problem here? What is the problem? Only thing is, I have not come to you as a client. Is that the only problem you have? I want you to know, the people who are working in the foundation, most of them, some of them are here, they are doctors, engineers, accountants. They have quit top high-paying jobs in their life and they are serving for free, all right? Thousands of them. And you have something against them, please. It's not about me because I don't do all that work. People are doing all that work, including the website and the commerce.
So just for the diversity of opinion, so that, I mean, as a moderator, I have to ask people from...
Oh, women's rights, yes. About Shani Signapur, see, first of all, you have a misunderstanding that Indian temple is a place of prayer. Indian temple is not a place of prayer, I want you to know this. Different temples were built in different ways for specific purposes. Shani temple is built for occult purposes. Occult means, you know what's occult? What is the Telugu word for occult? What? What is that? What people call as black magic or whatever, you know? there are certain occult practices, where if the occult practices are being done, women in state of pregnancy, in menstrual cycles, it could seriously impact their life. So they said women should not go. It was also designed that on a certain day, if the woman is in a certain condition, on a full moon day she can go, other days… These are prescriptions, these are not restrictions. These are prescriptions, these are not discriminations. These are done with a specific intent. Or now that you're talking about women's rights, why don't you fight for the men's rights? In our temple, the Bhairavi temple that we have, men are not allowed inside the sanctum. Why don't you stand up and fight for that? I will tell you why they're not allowed. That temple is only for the women. Men are not allowed. Why? Is it a discrimination? It is not about discrimination. It is a certain dimension of life. If you go by this crude sense of equality, you will harm the woman immensely. There are millions of temples open to everybody. Suddenly, why discrimination will come in one temple? What are you talking about? This is not a culture which discriminated against women. There are more female deities in this country than male deities. Every village you go, there is an Amman temple, there is a Devi temple. And you think it's discrimination? These are very rudimentary ideas picked up from the West. You have not seen this culture, you have not understood the profoundness with which is run. Unfortunately, because of 15-20 generations of poverty, we've kind of mixed it up and made a mess out of it. That is a different matter.
So, before I move on to another person, and he'll probably be the last person, before I move on to you, are the people there done with that particular question, or is there any further question on that particular issue? I mean, for diversity of opinion, I need to choose somebody from here. So, I mean, unless you don't have a further point on the same issue, I'll proceed. So, could somebody please give him the mic? Yeah.
Namaskaram, Sadhguru.
So, yeah, so if Job has a follow-up, then please proceed.
So, this…
I can't help it. I mean, if he's not satisfied with the same issue, he should be.
So, this crude sense of knowledge that you're talking about is the knowledge that's coming from the Supreme Court of the country.
Who is speaking?
So, this crude sense of knowledge that you say is the knowledge that's coming from the Supreme Court of the country.
Please listen to me.
Sir, you're still not addressing the point that who are you and I sitting here to make prescriptions for women and say that this is harmful for you, hence don't do it, or this is not harmful and you shouldn't do it. It's not up for you and I to do it. If it's harmful and they still want to do it, they are free to do it, right? I mean, you say that what people want to do in their bedroom, it's an individual choice. If women want to enter it, they want to enter it, who are us to stop it?
You ask a question, please. You please ask a question. I'm not that dumb that a question needs to be explained to me. You ask a question.
So you didn't answer it the first time, hence I'm explaining it.
You asked a question again, let me answer this, right? The question is, who are you to tell the ladies whether they should go to this or not?
No, I'm saying they should have the option.
So, I mean, just to give a similar example, sir, alcohol might be…
I got it. There are hundreds of temples in the country where men cannot enter. So if men
there's
say…
There's a history of discrimination.
That is a different matter. See, you're mixing up two things. Unfortunate history of discrimination on all levels. That's a different matter that has to be settled in a different way. But when a specific aspect comes, if you want to rule out all the subtler aspects of life and just say this is it. Anyway, let me tell you this. This I'm on camera, let me tell you this, okay? Supreme Court is there to interpret the constitution. It cannot create a new constitution. Doesn't matter what are the powers of the court. It cannot create a new constitution. It is only there to interpret the law the way it is. Am I right? You're all lawyers? Hello?
That's debatable.
When you debate that, there is going to be lots of problems because every pressure point, you know, people will apply. Every motivated group will push for their own laws. If you create enough ruckus, some law, new law will happen. This should not happen. It is essentially within the framework of the constitution, everything should happen. In the framework of the constitution, there are laws where there are public places and there are private temples and private places of worship. how it should be done there is left to them. It is for them to decide how it happens. Is it happening simply because of a discrimination against a gender? If it is so, it must be struck down absolutely. But if there are other aspects to it, if you think you cannot consider anything else, then it's ridiculous. It becomes ridiculous. It's like saying, don't I have the right to enter the ladies' toilet? What nonsense is this? Do you need a law? You just need sense that you don't go there.
Job, is your question answered? Like, or should
no,
I…
No, it's not answered, but that's then... okay.
It's not answered. Shall we answer, Mr. Job?
Okay, so…
I'm okay.
There's a difference between a man not allowed to enter a woman's woman's toilet and you using the same analogy.
I'm not saying he's not allowed. Man who is a man will not enter. That's all I said.
So that's a really stupid analogy that you're saying. We are discussing the question of women's entry to temple, and you're saying the reason why they're not allowed. Once again,
sir. I'm sorry, sir. You can continue with your question.
The problem, sir, is Mr. Joe. You do not know the culture of this nation. You're talking simply activism.
Yeah, because I'm Catholic, right?
Because in this country, in this culture, the idea of discrimination never arose. I want you to understand, even before other countries ever thought of even giving franchise to the woman, this country did not even debate whether women should have voting rights or not. It's simply there because in our culture, we never thought so. So the discrimination… Exploitation is there, I want you to understand, there is exploitation, there is no necessary discrimination. Exploitation is not just of the woman. Anybody who is weaker than you, people are exploiting, whether it's a man, woman or child. Why do you think everybody is beating the children? Just simply because they're small, not because they have a right to do it. So anything which is weaker than them, they're exploiting, not just women. Unfortunately, women have also been taken a much amount of beating in terms of exploitation. But do not misunderstand exploitation and discrimination in a fundamental way. Discrimination is a different aspect, exploitation is a different aspect.
I think, Job, we can agree to disagree here and let's move on. There's one last question we'll be picking up.
So, Sadhguru, we have two questions.
One at a time, I'm a simple guy.
Yeah, so first I'll ask and then one more. So, firstly, you said that from your years of practice and looking at people, you can just look at somebody and tell their past, present and future. Now, we'd really appreciate it if you could look at me and tell my past and present. Anything!
No, I am not an astrologer for you.
No, astrologer would be somebody who sees the future. I'm asking you only to see my past and present.
No, astrologers also talk about the past to get the market oriented, all right? I am not in that profession.
So when you say you're a mystic, what exactly do you mean? When your first answer to his question about first impressions was that you can see the past and the present while all of us mortals over here won't be able to do the same thing. So then fulfill his claim that you can tell us about his past or his present. But notwithstanding that, my question is different. My question is that you've spoken about how you believe that we must live in harmony with nature, etc. You told us that we've come here and we've taken over the land which belonged to snakes.
Well, that is true everywhere. Huh?
Correct. Taking you to the question
I'm so sorry to stop you, sir, in case you're not comfortable answering that.
I'm okay with any question. All right.
A lot of the infrastructure of the Isha Foundation has been built on elephant corridors.
Really?
Something which both the National Green Tribunal as well as the High Courts have admitted to without the requisite permissions. We tell you this goes against rule of law, which you stand for. This goes against living in harmony with species, both of which you've spoken right here at Nalsar. So if you could clarify regarding that.
Okay. there is a fan following for that also. So right now, all of you, those of you who are clapping and screaming, listen to me. You also, ma'am. What's your name? Huh?
Ankita.
Sanchita?
Ankita.
Ankita, okay. Now, we'll do one thing. I don't know what authority you have to say it's an elephant corridor. Listen, let me finish. The State Forest Department clearly has submitted to the High Court that this is not an elephant corridor. The Wildlife Trust of India has given a clear directive to the NGT that it's not an elephant corridor. The World Wildlife Fund says it's not an elephant corridor, but you say it's an elephant corridor. I don't know what's your relationship with the elephants, okay? If you do not understand, right now we put up the map published by the Wildlife Trust of India as to which are the elephant corridors and which are not. And elephant corridor is not anywhere in 100 kilometers of where we are. You can go look up the map today. Now, you can open up your cell phone and look it up now. So, being in a legal profession you're going to get into, first you must get your facts right, all right? And, well, I know where this is coming from. There are some activists who are going on publishing this endlessly. You're reading that social media is trash and you're coming to conclusions. Anyway, I want you to know, today if I want, by tomorrow evening, I can file 100 cases against you, all kinds of things. It's for you to come out of it in the next 20 years. This is the country you're living in, I want you to know. So, it doesn't matter, I will tell you further. For continuously, I've been accused of raising a rainforest. Which is that rainforest? Where was it? Please show it to me. There is no such forest, so they've kept quiet now because I asked these questions. Then they said, we have occupied forest lands. Well, forest department has senior forest officers from not only Tamil Nadu, from the center, came and surveyed the place and said not a little bit of encroachment has happened. But people keep writing the same thing. Now I'm asking you, if you're really interested in justice, you and your friends who are clapping for everything, I will ask you to come. 10, 15 of you come with cameras. I will give you all the maps, the survey maps and revenue maps and forest maps. You walk across, we'll give you total freedom to do the survey as you want, all right? If 1 inch, not 1 acre, 1 inch of forest land is taken, I have said this yesterday also, day before yesterday also, because I am surprised the same question is being asked, I will leave the country. You will not see me again. Is this good enough? Will you do it?
So we'll take one final question.
Sadhguru. No, let me finish this, huh? This is a charge, this is not a question. Now, if one little bit is taken, forest land, you will never see me again, you will never hear me again, okay? I'll be gone.
Okay.
Well, wait. I will tell you the kind of activism that is happening there. Why? I'm sure many of you may be associated with this, I'm saying this on camera, it can be published, I don't care what. Because I've reached a point where death threats are every day from these kind of people. Why all this is happening is, we are at the tri-junction of the 3 state borders. There are certain people who want to be active in the forest in that area and we've become a big problem for them. They want us ousted from there. That's not going to happen in their lifetime because it's not just for our interest. I want to make sure such activity doesn't happen in the forest and we have fought for this. So we're getting all this flack and for every little thing without knowing facts, being future lawyers, you must have little more facts on your hand. This is not the way to go to a court, you know?
One last question, the man in the blue shirt.
And now that you raise this question, I must finish this. Now that you raise this question and you charge me with this, if what you have said is not true, please go on the social media and say, I've been talking rubbish without knowing what are the facts.